Okay, follow along with this video to create and save a new MindMup file. We're going to create the new file. We're immediately going to take three steps, turn on argument visualization mode, turn on autosave, and give it a title. And then we are going to save, close, and reopen the file. What this will look like depends on whether you're using some combo of a computer and Google Drive or not using Google Drive at all. I'm going to illustrate the process using a computer and Google Drive first, and then I will go back and mention how the process will look a little different if you're using a mobile device or not using Google Drive at all. Okay, I am now in Google Drive. I've navigated to drive.google.com. I've already created a folder for this class, and within that folder, I created a special folder for my argument maps. I'm going to create a new MindMup file in the same way I would create any other kind of file, like a Google Doc. I click on New, and I navigate down to More, which opens another menu of different types of files, and I click on MindMup 2.0 for Google Drive. This pop-up that says Create in a Shared Folder is probably unique to me. It's a setting that I have on Google Drive. Okay, when it opens up, you are going to immediately take three steps. You are going to click View, Start Argument Visualization. View, Start Argument Visualization. When you do that, the blue box will turn white and the toolbar of tools will change. Perfect. Next, we're going to turn on autosave. There's a pop-up at the top here. You can also go to File, turn on autosave. That's File, turn on autosave. Perfect. Now we are going to give it a title. Let's call it My First Map. Those are the three steps. Let's close our map, and we can see there is some kind of new file here, but I'm going to refresh. There it is, my first map. To reopen this file, I navigate back to Google Drive and see my files in the folder where I left it, and I double click, and it should open it using MindMup. Perfect. Now, this process will look a little bit different if you're using a mobile device. If you're using a mobile device, there's no MindMup app, and you can't just go to the Google Drive app and open a MindMup file from within the Google Drive app. So what you will do instead is access MindMup through your browser, like Chrome or whichever browser you use. And you'll go to drive.mindmup.com. When you do, it will look like this, drive.mindmup.com. And you can see there's a button that says create a new map or open from Google Drive. You can also see I'm already signed in, so you might have to sign in if you haven't done so already. When you click create a map, this will create a map in your Google Drive, even though you're not in Google Drive. And if you've already done that and you've saved a map, you can open files from your Google Drive through this browser as well. Everything else will be the same. When you create a new map, you'll start in the generic concept mapping mode where you have the blue button, and you'll have to turn on argument visualization, and you'll want to turn on autosave and give it a title. What if you're not using Google Drive at all? Then again, you'll want to access MindMup through a browser, and this time just through argument.mindmup.com. The same place we went to connect Google Drive to MindMup, there's a blue button that says Create on MindMup Cloud. When I click this button, it opens a map, and notice that it doesn't have a blue button. It starts in argument visualization mode. There is no autosave option, and there is no title option. Now you can save it manually. There is a grayed out save button here. First, we have to do something to edit it, so there is something to save. There, I changed a box. And I click save. And this just tells me this file is only going to exist for 6 months. Okay, so I have a saved file. Now, how will I come back to it is the question. You are going to save the URL somewhere. So I'm going to copy it. Now, I recommend saving it wherever you save documents. I'm going to demo it using Google, even though obviously you're not using Google. That's why we're doing it this way. But the process will look the same if you're using Microsoft Word or whatever you use. So I'm going to create a new document. I'm going to copy and paste that link. I'm going to give this document my map title. And I also am going to take a screenshot of my map and stick it in here so I remember what the map is. Let's just add a little bit of extra detail so there's something to take a picture of. And let's forget to hit save. I'm going to take a screenshot. I'm on a Mac, so I'm using Command, Shift, and just the plain old number 4 to just take a partial screenshot. And then I'm going to drag and drop that into my document. So that way I have a link to the map that I can go back and edit, as well as a picture of the map as it exists so far. But let's say I forget to hit save. And I just close off. There's saves, changes I haven't saved. And I reopen this. There'll be a pop-up that says, there are unsaved changes. Would you like to discard them or apply them? If I hit apply, they'll come back. So that's how you will save and return to edit your MindMup maps without using Google Drive. And again, I highly recommend creating some other kind of file and including a screenshot of the map. There are other ways to take a picture of the map other than screenshots. I find screenshots to be the most useful, but you can also download as an image or a PDF. The nice thing about downloading as an image or taking a screenshot is that you can insert it into the document with that link. But you do it however you want to do it. Just have some kind of system.